monitored for years, with the results compared to a previous study shedding new light on the causes of cognitive decline.
Scott Cooper was once a senior bank executive until early onset dementia.
Pretty much had a photographic memory, and I was starting to not remember names, and I was getting confused.
Now he can't write.
Can't get my brain to talk to my hand.
There's international evidence the rate of new cases of dementia per 1,000 population is falling. It's prompted a major study here.
To see there's been a generational change, that the findings overseas are replicated in Australia.
Calling for 1,500 volunteers aged 70 to 90 from Sydney's east, assessing their physical, psychological, social and cognitive health, then comparing it to a similar study done in 2005. Some dementia risk factors have eased, like lower smoking rates and better blood pressure care.
But we also know that people are more socially isolated, and social isolation and loneliness are risk factors for dementia.
There's no cure for dementia, it's about prevention, slowing it down, and with a rapidly aging community, that's important for everybody.
Dementia's cost to the economy, $15 billion. By 2036, expected to soar to nearly $26 billion. And the impact on lives, research is trying to head off.
It's going to help people in the future. This is going to be a bit of a time bomb.
Chris Marr, 7 News.
Actor and comedian Stephen Fry has been rushed to hospital after falling off stage in London. The 66-year-old had just delivered a speech at an AI conference when he fell around 2 metres. Fry was treated for rib and leg injuries. There has been no further update on his condition. However, it's believed he remains in hospital. Time now for a check on the markets with finance editor Gemma Acton. Gemma, yet another day in the red.
Yes, Mark, nearly another 100 points locked off the ASX 200 today, taking it down to a 10-week low. Technology was the only sector to avoid the sell-off. The Aussie dollar has lost some ground. Now it's back closer to 64 US cents once again, while oil has also come off its recent highs. And the renovation boom during the pandemic years tailed off fairly quickly last year, but we are still borrowing far more to update and upgrade our homes than we were before COVID. That's partly because renovating is a lot more expensive today, but it's also partly because